In this video, we will talk about some of the Gmail shortcuts. So not all of these shortcuts are useful, but most of them you can use in your everyday working. And let's say you save only 15 minutes using these shortcuts. So at the end of the year, you might have saved 60 hours. So that is enough time to make a justification for learning these shortcuts. And it's really not very hard to learn these shortcuts. And first of all, before you can use these shortcuts, you have to enable them. So in order to enable them, again, go to your settings and then settings again. So look at this general tab and make sure you are in this general tab, and then you scroll down. And here you can see that keyboard shortcuts. So currently I have turned these on. So these are enabled in my interface. Now let's say you are in Inbox. So now first of all, I would like to mention that how you can check what shortcuts are available to you. So in order to see all these shortcuts, you simply press Shift and question mark, and you will be presented with this console. So this console has all the shortcuts available to you. But the most commonly used, I am going to show you today. So you mostly use those shortcuts, not all of them. You don't have to remember them. When you will be using those shortcuts, you will automatically remember the important ones. So the first thing is, for example, let's say you are in the inbox and you want to compose a new email. So as you might have guessed, just press C. So this was to start a new email. And now let's say you have opened an email and you want to reply this email. So in order to reply, simply press R, and as you can see that now you are replying this email. So this is another very useful shortcut. So let's say you want to select all these unread messages and you want to delete them, because these are not useful. You don't want to archive them, you just want to delete them. So in order to select all unread messages, you have to press Shift 8 U. So Shift 8. And then I press U. So you have to press Shift 8 U all together. So then all the unread messages will be selected. So if you want to delete them, simply press delete and these messages will be gone. If you don't want to delete them, you want to just unselect, then you have to click here. So these will be unselected. So let's say you want to archive these unread messages. So what you do, Shift 8 and U first, all the selected. And then in order to archive, just press E. These messages have been archived. So you can undo anytime, or you can just press Z. And if you press Z, all your previous action will be undone. So now these messages are back. So Z is to undo any action. Similarly, you can use these arrows to go up and down in your inbox, and also J and K. So K is for up and J is for down, because J, K is normally on the keyboard. So it's easy to use J, K. So they have provided this shortcut for going up and down. Let's say you want to go to your starred emails. All the starred emails are stored in this folder, starred folder. So what you do, G and then S. So G and then S. Now we are in the starred folder. As you can see, that starred is highlighted. Now you want to go back to inbox. So G and I. So G and I, and you are back into inbox. So when you your hands are on the keyboard, so it's easier to just use the keyboard instead of going for mouse and then going into inbox. So let's say that you have sent an email and you want to verify that the email has been sent. So just press G and T. So you will be in the sent folder. So G and then T. So now you are in the sent folder. So these were some of the shortcuts. You can check anytime with Shift question mark, and you can see that whether any of other are useful for you. I hope that this will help you to decide which shortcut you want to use.